The Sabbath means Saturday in the New Testament. It does not mean a holy day. So that Sabbath, that Saturday, was a special Sabbath. You know why? Because it fell in Passover week. It was in the Passover week. Jesus died on the 15th of Nisan, a Friday, which was actually a holy day, amazingly. He rose on the Sunday, on the 17th of Nisan, when the first fruits would be offered. And so the day of that Sabbath, remember, Sabbath does not mean a holy day. It might in the Old Testament on one occasion, but it's just wrong to say that Sabbath is an annual Sabbath. It's not true. They are festivals. The weekly Sabbath and the new moons are in a calendar, a trio of calendar. But so he's simply saying there, the day of that Saturday happened to be a special day. Namely, it was the Sabbath falling in the Passover week. I recommend you have a look at the wonderful summary of all of this in A.T. Robinson's Harmony of the Gospels. There's an appendix on this. I have no doubt that Jesus died on the 15th. He kept the Passover on the 14th. You know, they celebrated the Passover at the beginning of the 15th, at the end of the 14th. The end of the 14th, about afternoon time, they killed the lamb. And that evening, which was the beginning of the 15th of Nisan, Jesus kept the Passover as the nation did. That's absolutely clear in Matthew, Mark, and Luke. Start there. Don't start with John. The rest of the story can be worked out, provided you don't throw away Matthew, Mark, and Luke. So then, on that Thursday, Jesus, of the evening, what we would call Thursday, the beginning of the 15th in the Jewish reckoning, they had that supper, that Passover supper. Jesus took the Passover. Did he take a lamb there? It doesn't say. Maybe he did, maybe he didn't. Maybe he said, well, I'm the lamb, so we're going to substitute myself as the lamb. But he didn't die on the day of the Passover. He died on the day after that. You can't eat the Passover, as the nation did, and die at the same time. That's quite obvious. So I would argue, and you can look again at that A.T. Robertson Harmony. It's probably online. Marvelous discussion. And many others have seen this. So an ancient tradition, I think, got that wrong. And some people even said that Jesus died on a Wednesday and rose on a Saturday. That's completely wrong. That's to base one's whole theology of the resurrection on a Hebrew idiom which speaks of 3 days and three nights. Yes, I know what that means to you in modern English, but you're not reading modern English in the Bible. It's quite wrong to contradict all the easy evidence about the third day. And the third day from Sunday is Friday, by the way. So if you want a really good proof text for this, Luke 24:21 says that today, Sunday, is the third day since the crucifixion. That's brilliant. That's counting inclusively as Luke reports Jesus as having done exactly that. Jesus speaks about today, tomorrow, and the third day, twice, I think, in Luke 13. Count that backwards. Sunday, yesterday, Saturday, and the third day backwards is Friday. No need to mess with that tradition. There's a lot of very amateur, may I say, and I was guilty of that myself. We didn't know enough to tackle some of these not too difficult language issues. So if you look at the great commentaries, Ellicott, Lang's commentary, many of the commentaries online now, you don't need to own them.
We also have a couple of translations here that might help. Mm-hmm. So the NIV in John 19:14 says that mm-hmm. the day of preparation, Friday of mm-hmm. Passover week.
Got it. Yes.
And Tyndale wrote, it was the Sabbath, even, that is Eve, mm-hmm. evening before Saturday, which falls in the Easter feast.
That's right. The key there is that John uses the word Passover to mean the Passover week. You can use it also for the Passover day, which was, of course, the 15th of Nisan. But you can also use it, as John does, meaning the whole week. So that's the key. And I'm glad I didn't know until you put that up that Tyndale saw that. Many commentators have seen it, and there's no need for any dispute or argument over anything in that regard because of Luke 24:21. Today, Sunday. This is a marvelous passage because they're walking on the road to Emmaus, and they encounter Jesus without even knowing who he is. And they say to Jesus, haven't you heard about the guy that got killed by the Romans? And then they say, today, talking on the first day of the week, today, Sunday, is the third day since that awful event. And then Jesus reveals himself to them. That is beautiful, but it's been confused and complicated horribly by very amateur attempts to explain 3 days and three nights as literally 72 hours. Note that Matthew's parallels with the Old Testament are not exactly our Western parallels. For example, Isaiah 7 is quoted as being proof of the virgin birth. It's not actually literally so. There wasn't a literal virgin birth in the day of Ahaz. There was a young lady who became pregnant. It was a sign. Notice that Jonah was not dead in the whale, was he? The parallel is partial. God works in patterns. And we come along with our very Western picky approach to everything, and we say, well, it's got to be exactly word by word right. What if it isn't? What if it's a beautiful parallel between Jonah being in the fish's belly with Jesus being actually dead, and he was fully unconscious, dead from Friday to Sunday. And Sunday is the eighth day of the week, the beginning of the new creation. What a marvelous day to celebrate the resurrection. Sunday is not the Sabbath. The weekly Sabbath on the seventh day is of no relevance to you now under the new covenant.